For $10. It's a simple question, but sometimes the answers are cashing in on a much deeper story. And this is something author Carlos Fontana learned when he asked this question to hundreds of people. He joins us now this morning with his daughter for more on the book Priceless, 66 Simple Stories of Reflection, Love, and Legacy. Guys, thanks for being with us. We appreciate
Thank you for having us.
So I love the background of this book, and I want to know more about how you got the idea to do this.
Well, many years ago, I read in a book that this individual, the author, asked people the question, and these were people that lived great lives, and what if they were to live again, what would they do differently? And interesting, it came three themes that came out of that was I would reflect more. I mean, think about it. We live in a fast-paced society. Right. Who's got time to reflect? I would love more. And I would do more things they would continue after I'm gone. And that never left me. This was many years ago. And about 3 years ago, talking with a friend, a neighbor, he mentioned, when are you going to write your book? And that started a chain of events. The idea came. And then I asked a reflective question. What's the best value that you spend in your life for about $10? And you'd be amazed at the answers that came. And when it got all said and done, those answers were about reflection, love, and legacy. And to me, it was amazing the transformation that I personally went through during that process, what I've learned. And at the end, I mean, really what I found is that every one of us have in us the ability to live great lives. The only really difference between people that live great lives and those that don't is a personal decision that you're going to do something great with your life. We all have in us that ability. So it was a little bit of a long process, but it was a lot of fun,
yeah.
Especially having my daughter to work with me.
I was going to say that process probably was helped a little bit by your daughter. Talk about your contribution to the book and how you helped your dad.
Well, when he first came to me, he actually asked me the question. And so I was like, you know, what's going on with this? And, you know, then he kind of started snowballing into this huge project. And so once he had all the stories, we got to work together going through all of them and editing and compiling them. And we added reflection questions to them. And it was a lot of fun to get to work together, especially because a lot of fathers and daughters don't get to spend as much time together once, you know, you move away and everything. And for most of it, I lived out of state. And so we got to spend a lot of time together that we wouldn't have normally gotten to see each other, so it was a lot of fun.
So I'm curious to know, what were some of the most interesting responses that you got from this?
Well, the most common responses were like, it was my marriage certificate, it was a book, it was a money that I gave to a stranger, I bought a lunch to somebody. So there were some things that were repetitive, but there were things very profound. I mean, things, for an example, a young man went to a meeting with his father. And that happened to be the last day that he saw, really spend some time with his father, because a few days later, his father passed away in a construction accident.
Oh, wow.
And, you know, and so when you reflect on that, it's life really is truly priceless.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's the little things that we do every day that we don't even think that they have huge ripple effects. And so simple things, $10 is a sum that we spend often.
Yeah,
and
something to think about, for sure.
Something to think about, because before we do things, because that could have an enormous impact.
So the book comes out tomorrow, right?
Correct, tomorrow.
And where can people go very quickly for more information on getting it?
Well, they can go to our website, pricelessbooksforlife.com. It's all one word. And find it there. And we also have a blog and a list of our events, or they can check the events page on there and see what where our next book signing will be.
Okay. Guys, it sounds like a great read. Thanks for coming in this morning again. We appreciate it.
You're very welcome. Thank you for having us.
Of course. All right. It is 8:26. Of course, more information at fox17online.com. Just make sure you go to the morning news page and scroll down to the news section. Still ahead this morning, we're learning more about a plane crash in